are the KidVision Kids, and we're here today to find out how to make chocolate.
Well, welcome. You're in the perfect place. I'm Carolina. I'm the owner of Exquisito. Follow me.
Great. Let's go. I'm really excited to learn about chocolate. Where does it all start?
So it all starts on a farm with a cacao tree. We'll take a little trip with our virtual reality. Can you see the cacao tree?
What happens with that fruit that you see on the tree? What is that called?
So it's a cacao pod, and it grows from a flower that grows on the trunk of the tree.
And where's the chocolate?
The chocolate's inside the cacao pod, so there's a fruit that eventually becomes chocolate.
I see that in there's a man that's cutting a piece of, what would it be called?
It's the cacao pod.
Cacao pod, it's very interesting. What is this we have here?
So that's the cacao pod. It looks a little bit like a pomegranate on the outside, and then on the inside is where the fruit grows, and that's the beans that you see in front of you.
This is one that hasn't been opened yet. It's just dried out. It's very light. And then the other thing we're gonna pick up is we're gonna pick up the seeds and talk about the seeds.
So it has an outer shell. It's a little bit like a peanut. The inside part is what we eat. That's what becomes chocolate. And then the outer shell, it's like the peanut. We don't use or eat that.
Far, what's the next step?
So the next step is we're gonna sort through the beans to pick out the best ones.
These dried beans?
Correct.
Okay, let's do it. Tell me about the tray of beans that we have in front of us.
So these beans, the cacao beans, are the dried fruit that came from the cacao tree.
Oh, so it could be called a cocoa tree too, or cocoa beans or cacao.
Yes, they're all valid ways of saying it. So since we're handling food, we're gonna put on gloves first.
Why would we put on gloves?
To protect our hands and the beans.
Right, to protect our hands and the beans.
And keep them clean.
Exactly, to keep them clean. And what are we sorting? And why are we sorting?
So we're sorting because we want to find the good beans, so the beans that will ultimately become chocolate. So the things that we don't want in our chocolate, anything like this stem, which was what held the pod to the tree. And then also any sort of beans that we don't want, but beans that are not good, that are open.
We're sorting the beans and the stems. Do they feel hard or soft?
Hard.
Do you think they would be good for eating right now?
No.
Do you think they'd be too hard to eat on your teeth?
Yes.
So our next step is we have to roast them and then we'll break them open.
Spread them out so they're nice and even for the oven.
Why are we roasting the beans?
We want to develop the flavor of the bean and then also puff it up so we can take the shell off.
So the heat does that?
Yes, it evaporates the rest of the water so that way it can take the shell out.
Perfect. What temperature are we roasting at?
So we're gonna do 270 degrees Fahrenheit.
For how long?
For about 20 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah, we're not there yet.
What's the next step?
So next, we've already puffed up the bean, and what we need to do is remove the husk or the shell.
Can you show us how to do that?
Absolutely. So if we were to take a hammer and we were to crush the bean, you'd have two parts. You'd have the shell or the husk and then the cocoa nib. So the nib is the heavier part, which is the fruit. If we were to take the hairdryer, see, we're gonna be left with the nib right here, which is what ultimately becomes chocolate.
So to find the chocolate, you need a hammer and a hairdryer? Or there must be a machine for
yes.
that?
We do have our winnowing machine, which cracks and separates the bean from the nib. It's the nib itself is what becomes chocolate.
Oh, so the cocoa nib is actually chocolate.
Exactly. It's the purest form of chocolate that you can have.
So everyone take a couple of nuts. What is this part called? What is the outside part of this bean called? Shell. And what's inside the coca shell? The nib. And what is the nib actually?
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Are we done yet?
Almost.
Almost. Almost. Wait, what's the next step?
So we're gonna then take our nibs and put it into our refining machine to make chocolate.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Thumbs up. We're ready.
Awesome.
Well, today we're talking about chocolate, and now we're getting to the final good part.
Yes.
So what is chocolate?
So chocolate comes from a fruit from a cacao tree, and we turn it into candy to make things like truffles and ice creams and all sorts of yummy stuff.
So chocolate is actually a fruit?
It is. It comes from a fruit, and we mix it in with a few different ingredients to make the final product.
What's the difference between white chocolate, dark chocolate, and milk chocolate?
So dark chocolate and milk chocolate both have cacao nibs, and then white chocolate doesn't have any. It has sugar, cacao butter, and milk powder.
So white chocolate has no chocolate in it?
There's no nibs in white chocolate.
So now we're gonna make some white chocolate that you already have going, and the ingredients are?
Sugar, cocoa butter, and milk powder.
And if we wanted to add our ingredients, because ingredients make our chocolate, how should we put it in?
So we would sprinkle in a little bit of sugar and let it refine down.
Now we're gonna make milk chocolate. Milk chocolate has the same ingredients as white chocolate. What are those ingredients?
Sugar, milk powder, and cocoa butter.
And then one more thing, which is the nibs that we already have in here.
So the nibs have been going around and around, and look at, they've liquefied. They've gone from hard to liquid. Dark chocolate only has three ingredients. It has
nibs, cocoa butter, and sugar.
Right, and the nibs have been in there, the ones that you separated have been in there aerating and getting liquefied. Now, it's time for the taste test. Tell us about it.
It's the best part, so we're gonna start by tasting out the dark chocolate, and then we're gonna taste the milk chocolate, which is right in the middle.
That's pretty good.
And then the final one will be your white chocolate, which will be the sweetest one.
Which one do you think?
I think the milk chocolate.
You like the milk chocolate? I like the milk chocolate. Which one do you think?
White chocolate.
White chocolate? Two milk chocolates, one white chocolate. What's your favorite?
Dark chocolate.
Thank you, Miss Carolina. Now we know all about how chocolate is made.